Andara Natishan, my friend. You have come a long way. I give you the welcome of our clan. These are curious companions you have. Might I ask the purpose of your visit? The Grey Wardens? You have joined their ranks? How unusual! Excuse my surprise. I will take you to the Keeper right away.
I see we have a guest. And one of our own, no less.
This one is from one of our sister clans to the north, Keeper, but claims to have come on behalf of the Grey Wardens.
The Grey Wardens? How unusual that one of our own should join their ranks. How did such a thing occur? Perhaps so. At the moment, I'm afraid I have little time to spare for long tales. Masirinus Mithra, you may return to your post.
Manuvinan, Keeper.
Now, perhaps we might introduce ourselves. I am Zathrian, Keeper and Harren of this clan. You are? If you came to bring news of the Blight in the south, it is not needed. I had already sensed its corruption. I would have taken the clan north by now, had we the ability to move. Sadly, as you can see, we do not. Do not allow our troubles to burden you, though I suspect they may impact your mission. I imagine you are here regarding the treaty we signed centuries ago. Unfortunately, we may not be able to live up to the promise we made. This will require some explanation. Please, follow me. The clan came to the Brazilian forest 1 month ago, as is our custom when we enter this part of Ferelden. We are always wary of the dangers in the forest, but we did not expect the werewolves would be lying in wait for us. They ambushed us, and though we drove the beasts back, much damage was done. Many of our warriors lie dying as we speak. Even with all our magic and healing skill, we will eventually be forced to slay our brethren to prevent them from becoming beasts. The Blight's evil must be stopped. But we are in no position to uphold our obligations. I am truly sorry. The affliction is a curse that runs rampant in their blood, bringing great agony and then ultimately either death or a transformation into something monstrous. The only thing that could help them must come from the source of the curse itself. And that would be no trivial task to retrieve. Within the Brazilian forest dwells a great wolf. We call him Witherfang. It was within him that the curse originated, and through his blood that it has been spread. If he is killed and his heart brought to me, perhaps I could destroy the curse. But this task has proven too dangerous for us. I sent some hunters into the forest a week ago, but they have not returned. I cannot risk any more of my clan. There is no guarantee that this will work, as I suspect, but it's the only hope we have left. I must warn you that more than werewolves lurk in the Brazilian forest. It has a history full of carnage and murder, you see. Where there is so much death, the veil separating the spirit realm from our own becomes thin, allowing spirits to possess things, living or dead. But if you can indeed help, then I wish you luck. Make them quick, if you please. I have much to do here. My apprentice Lanaya or Seyrel, the clan's storyteller, could provide you with answers just as easily. Watch for the white wolves. They are his eyes and ears in the forest. There is not much to say. It stemmed originally from Witherfang, but now any werewolf may infect someone with it. No. The ones from this forest, however, do. It is possible, but not guaranteed. The only way to protect against the curse is not to be bitten. You will know within a matter of days. You will begin to sweat and vomit, and most tellingly, your temper will become wild and uncontrollable. If that happens to you, you should seek out Witherfang even more swiftly. Your mission at that point will be rather personal. That is a long tale I do not have time to tell. Ask Sayrel about it if you wish. Go on, then. I must return to caring for my people. Creator's speed on your way.
Undere and Atishin, Lethaline. My name is Lanaya, Zathrian's first. I hear your clan has moved on to the north, and that you're now one of the Grey Wardens. Allow me to congratulate you for stepping into a world that few of our people even dream of. I wish I could do the same. I must admit, I am a bit jealous. I have too many duties to my clan to do more than dream of such travels. Perhaps, since you have traveled in the outside world yourself, might I ask you a question or two? I hear the human cities are very large, thousands upon thousands of souls all packed together in their houses. Is that true? How very loud that must be with everyone talking all at once. I try to imagine those of our people living in such a place, surrounded by walls of stone and indifference. It is a difficult thought. Being accustomed to pain and suffering does not make it any less tragic. It is said that one day we will have a land of our own. We Dalish gather the ancient wisdom in preparation for this. When that day comes, all elves, even those who have forgotten, will reclaim their former glory. I have one more question, though I'm not sure you can answer it. Do the humans ever regret what they did to us? And yet, even if some regret, they do nothing. A poet once wrote of them before the fall of the Dales. Like dragons, they fly, glory upon wings. Like dragons, they savage, fearsome, pretty things. But you don't need me to quote poetry to you. Forgive me. Perhaps you have some questions of your own. Nothing that you could not ask Zathrian himself. He is the keeper of this clan and has been for a very long time. He is also a very good man who has lost much. The Dalish are everything to him, and he would do anything to protect them. He lost his family a very long time ago. I don't know the story, but I understand the circumstances were horrific. I'm hardly anyone special, I assure you. If I seem different from the rest of my clan, it's only because I was born amongst humans. I came to the Dalish at a very young age, but I've always retained my curiosity about the world I came from. My parents were servants to a human merchant whose caravans plied the southern routes. One day, bandits killed him, and my parents both. I was the only survivor, just a young girl, and the bandits took me. I was their servant for several years. It was, though long years of reflection have allowed me to come to terms with it, to put them in perspective. I can only imagine what would have happened had the clan not saved me from them. I owe them my life for that, and more. The bandits killed a scout when the clan passed near their camp. When the clan discovered him, Zathrian came looking for his killers. He followed their tracks for almost a month, and when he finally caught up to us, he fell on the bandits like a terror. No one could stop him. I sat there, and I watched him attack them in a blur. And I reveled in every blow. When he saw me, the fury in his eyes turned to pity. He took me back to the clan, and I've been here ever since. It's possible I might have had some, maybe many. Zathrian offered to take me back, but I had no idea where I was from, and I wanted to stay with a man who rescued me. The clan is my family. Any others out there, it's best they believe that little girl died with her parents. For now, the clan is all I need. My old world could not have offered me all this, and the knowledge of a keeper as well. Perhaps one day, when I am keeper, I might inquire out of curiosity. I'm not sure what lies down that road except pain, however. I am not a keeper. I am Zathrian's first. Though because I was not born into the clan, becoming his first was very difficult. We Dalish have old traditions. The clans come from the ranks of the nobility that once ruled the Dales, you see. The keepers of those old clans have the strongest and purest blood that reaches back to the days of Arlathan. I had to compete against the other candidates for first, to be better than them in everything, simply because I was not of the old blood. I am. The ceremony where Zathrian anointed me as his first was the proudest day of my life. The clan has placed great trust in me. One day, I will lead them and be the one who secures our future. As you wish. Darth Shirel.
Andaren Atishan, Lethaline. Would you come and help us break our fast? Come then and sit. Join us by the fire. I am Harant Sayril, the clan storyteller. You have one in your own clan, I assume. Ah, Haren Pyvel still lives. That is good, for he was old even when I was but Dalen. How lucky you are to have been reared with his tales. I notice you are not alone. These companions of yours are Grey Wardens like yourself?
I am a golem, obviously.
Zevran here. We have Dalish up in Antiva City, though they're much more violent, I hear.
I am Wyn, Sayril. It is wonderful to meet you.
Andaren Atishan, enter this place in peace. I do find it odd that any of your kind would so readily follow one of the Dalish. Do you suppose you have been made a Grey Warden simply to get our assistance? Maybe they think we would not live up to the treaty otherwise. Oh, you do, do you? No offense, young one, but you don't know half the...
Please, Harant Sayril, you are being most unkind to one who is not only of our blood, but also a guest who is here to help us.
Of course. I apologize for my rudeness. Our losses have been great, and I am... not myself.
The Harant's own wife has perished from the werewolf's curse. We are mourning her death here, and many more to come.
We are glad to hear it. I should not have suspected otherwise. These have not been easy days for us. And the idea that we may yet have to abandon our ill to their fate. But let us not dwell on our problems. Is there something we can do to help you in your quest?
I appreciate you trying to find him, but what are the chances?
Anaren the healer?
You know Anaren? He lives? No. It can't be him. Perhaps it is a common elven name.
No, I know of only one Anaren.
Ah, it makes sense. Anaren said that he was from the human cities. You are old friends, then.
If you seek Anaren, you must venture into the forest. He prefers to be amidst the trees and the animals.
Thank you all so much.
I know a few tales. Our clan has passed this way many times before, even when the Shemlin lived in these parts. You wish? I can tell you what I know. It is not a long story. Our legends say that before the Shemlin came, the Brasilian forest was a place of our ancestors that predated even our oldest homeland. The people of the Imperium came here and gave the forest its name. If they found traces of our ancestors, we cannot say. If they did, those elves were slain or enslaved. We know only that a great many battles were fought here. These trees grow upon the graves of those who fell, Shemlin and elves both. Indeed, very wise of you. There was so much death that the veil into the beyond was torn. The Shemlin know the beyond as the Fade, the place of dreams and spirits. When the veil is torn, spirits pass into our world freely. The legends say that one great spirit possessed the wolf that became Witherfang, who passed its curse of rage onto men and created werewolves. So Zathrian insists. He says that Witherfang does not age as the werewolves do. Witherfang is as much spirit as it is beast, and thus it is immortal. Perhaps it cannot even be slain. At the very least, it is old and powerful, much as Zathrian himself. The forest is said to be haunted. Spirits possess the trees, the wolves, even the bodies of the dead. They yearn for true life, you see. Who can say what value the Imperium placed on this land? And how many elves died here, in slavery? Even the barbarians, who came to overthrow the Imperium, fought and died on this soil. No one knows. When the Shemlin lived in these parts, the curse would spread anew to a few of them with each passing year. They would run off into the forest, never to be seen again. Eventually, all the Shemlin left. One assumes the werewolves survive by passing their curse to their offspring. They have had no new blood. Until now, that is. It is said that one or two have turned already, though the Keeper denies it. As for the rest, they will either die or turn, unless they are killed out of mercy. I would rather die than become a ravening, soulless beast, wouldn't you? One last warning. The forest is like a thing alive. It changes as it wills, closing paths behind you and opening up new ones. Too many have become lost within, unable to find their way out. Were I you, I would endeavor not to make the forest my enemy. Anathara, my friend, join us if you like. We know only what Zathrian has told us over the years. I never saw one myself until the attack. Some of us have wondered. The Keeper says they are simply cunning, that any beast can lie in wait. But this seemed more than that.
It was planned. These are no simple beasts.
Then the real question is why the Keeper would insist that it is not so. I do not believe he would. But even the wisest of men do not always see the truth in front of them, nor do they always wish to. The hunters say they have strength and speed far beyond what's ordinary, and are as tough as such beasts come. Like wolves, they hunt in packs so as to combine their strength. But in the end, a blade kills them as surely as it does any other. What you need to fear is their bite. If you are infected, you are done, though not right away, and not all at once. As you know, they can shapeshift into wolves, allowing them to hide amidst the true wolves. Other than not to get bitten? Not that I know of. Of course. You wish something else? Darth Shirol.
You are the Dalish Grey Warden. And Darren Atishan. It is good to meet you. I am Kamen, a hunter apprentice, though I wish I could become a real hunter. I suppose there's no harm in telling you. You know our ways. I've been an apprentice for too long. To become a true hunter, I must bring back the pelt of a beast I killed myself, a boar or a wolf or something. I wanted to hunt in the forest, but we're forbidden to enter because of the attack. But the real problem is Gaina. She's my heart's desire. I have asked for her hand, but she cruelly refuses it. She will not bond with an apprentice, she says, and calls me a child. I am no child. If I was a hunter, I could prove it, but I cannot hunt, and Gaina will never bond with me. I feel so helpless. I shouldn't have brought it up. Just leave me to my misery. You think I haven't thought about this? There's nothing I can do. I suppose you could, but what good would that do? The situation hasn't changed. Really? I'm willing to try anything. Siranus. Oh, Ma Siranus. I will pray to the goddess of love that you are successful.
Welcome to our clan. It is good to see more of my own people from elsewhere. You spoke to him? What did he say? I am embarrassed to talk about this to you, but I simply cannot accept his proposal. He's been a hunter apprentice for over 2 years now, and he's yet to slay a proper beast. Each time he's tried, something has gone wrong. Perhaps the creators do not wish us to bond. I cannot bond with an apprentice hunter, can I? But what if he never becomes a proper hunter? What will become of our family? Oh, you are right! I have made poor Kamen miserable. No wonder he cannot complete his hunt. Ma Siranus, thank you. You have helped me put this into perspective. I will go and speak to Kamen. Kamen, I have been a fool.
Gaina? What do you mean? Have you changed your mind?
I have. The Outsider has helped me to see that I was wrong. I have made you miserable, and I should not have.
But what about my hunt?
I don't care about that. I know you will pass your hunt in time, and we will be happy. Us and our children.
Thank you, Gaina. You've made me a happy man. I feel blessed by the gods today. We are both very grateful for the part you've played in bringing us together.
How marvelous you are. I am so happy.
Here, take this. It's been in my family for a very long time, but I hope it plays some part in your battle against the Darkspawn. It's the very least we could do.
Who comes? Anathara. I was so busy attending the Hala, I did not hear you coming. I fear she may have been bitten during the werewolf attack. I have tried speaking with her, but she is too agitated for me to understand. The curse would not affect her as it would us, but it would still be lethal. And it may prove contagious to the other Hala as well. I can find no wound on her, but if she's truly ill, then I will have to put her out of her misery, for her sake as well as that of the others. I don't know. Do you have any skills that might help her? If you do, I would be grateful. And? What do you think? I am glad you attempted it, regardless. Yes, that's it. She's calming down. That's it, love. Be calm. Tell me what troubles you. Ah, I see. It is her life mate who is sick, not her. He was bitten on the leg during the attack, and she fears greatly for him. I did not realize another Hala was injured. This will allow me to prevent the sickness from spreading to the entire herd. Ma Siranus, thank you. You have done my clan a great boon this day. I will always be grateful for your help.
It seems the Keeper has charged you with a difficult task. Do you feel up to it? I am glad to hear that, Letheline. Surely the creators have sent you to us. That one of our own people comes to us in our hour of need gives us great comfort. You will find yourself welcome here.
Anathara, friend. It is good to see another of the wandering clans. Where is your clan now, if I might ask? I see. I am glad you have become part of such a respectful organization as the Grey Wardens, however. I understand you will search for the wolves in the Brazilian forest. I would join you, but Zathrian has forbidden me. We are banned from entering the forest now. I have more cause than most, but I will not disobey my keeper. I suppose there's no harm in telling a fellow elf, but surely you have greater concerns than any problem of mine, no? Well, perhaps you could help me with it. I would certainly appreciate anything you could do. My wife Denyla and I both fought the werewolves in the ambush. She was injured so gravely, the curse spread rapidly in her. Zathrian fought hard to ease her pain, but there was little he could do. And though he says that Denyla is dead, he will not let me see her. Her body. I am beginning to believe she became a werewolf. And that it is being kept from me so I do not go chasing after her.
And if she was a werewolf, and the elf chased her and then found her, what then? Sweet, blissful reunion?
I don't know. Maybe she would know me as her love, even still?
More likely she would love to eat you.
If I could just know if Denyla is alive, or what happened to her, then I could be at peace. I have an amulet made by our craftsmen. It's not much, but I would be happy to give it to you in return for any news.
What are you doing? You've warped the wood completely. Did you leave it out in the rain?
No, Master Ferrothorn. I think I just used too much heat.
You're not smelting ore like a Durgenlin. This is living wood. It requires patience and delicate hands, not more heat.
My actions bring me sorrow, Master Ferrothorn.
And so they should. Truly, the art will be lost to us forever at this rate. Throw away your dead wood and start anew, and I shall speak to our guest. And dear Natitian friend, it has been some years since I met Master Island at the last gathering. He is still hale, I hope. That is good to hear. Your clan is more familiar to us than most, since we do not stray far from each other in this land. I met your father, for he was once keeper of your clan. You carry many of his features. He spoke at a gathering, telling the clans that more of us need to voyage into the Shemlin world and learn their ways. He would be proud to see his son a Grey Warden, I think. Our people speak so little of the dead, especially those who end in tragedy. I thought you should know, regardless. What little of the craft I've learned has been passed on to me through generations. Such is the time it has taken us to learn a fraction of what has been lost. I do not make bows as fine as Master Island's, perhaps, but mine have caused more than one Shemlin to drool at the thought of possessing them. There is wood that, if treated properly, is as hard as steel, but far lighter. It grows only in this forest. Ironbark. The keeper has forbidden us from entering the forest to collect the wood. This means I cannot make our finest crafts for years to come. I would be hesitant to ask it of you, but if you should come across ironbark, I suppose there would be no harm in gathering some. It is blue and very distinctive. You can only harvest the bark which has fallen off the tree from age. Now, if you find some, bring it to me, and I will craft it for you. That would please me, so long as our hunters come first. I am no merchant, but let us trade. Perhaps there's something here which will be of value to you.
Yes? What is it you need? Have you news? And what did she have to say? That's true. Hundreds of years, if you must know. Slowly the Dalish will all know once again the agelessness of the elves. For now, only a few of us have regained that ability. But I cannot say any more on that. I trust your curiosity is sated. I would rather not speak of it. It is very painful for me, even now after so long. The werewolves were responsible. That is all you need to know, and should adequately explain my hatred of them, no? Let us leave it at that. Make them quick, if you please. I have much to do here. My apprentice Lanaya or Sayrel, the clan's storyteller, could provide you with answers just as easily. She was one of the first to succumb to the curse. She is dead. Athras is a grief-stricken man who seeks hope that does not exist. He will accept what has happened in time. I must return to caring for my people. Creator's speed on your way.